Hello, I'm Professor John Kelly, and this is the Weber Auto YouTube channel. I am very excited today to show you a new feature that Tesla has just released with their latest firmware update. You can take a screenshot of the center screen and save it to your computer. Now, this requires access to Tesla's diagnostic software, the Toolbox software, which is not free, but once you have access to that software, you can take screenshot in just the regular user interface mode, any of the service mode screens or panels, and in service mode plus. So here are some examples of screenshots that I've taken on our 2018 Model 3 back here and our 2022 Model Y. And it just has incredible detail. Now, why is this a big deal? Why am I nerding out about this? Because I'm a teacher. I teach classes on Tesla electric vehicles and other electric vehicles in the hybrid and electric vehicle boot camps that I offer every year. And I'm constantly having to, either myself or with an assistant, take photographs of the screens on the Tesla vehicles for diagnostics, for familiarization, and so on. And the photographs almost always don't turn out like you want, and you have to go back in and edit the photographs to straighten them out and get the color right and everything else. And so now it's just easy to do once you have the Toolbox software. So to gain access to the Toolbox software, if you'll just go to service.tesla.com, as you can see here on this screen, and then there's a diagnostic link. You click on that and diagnostic software, and you can see the price for using it for a day, a month, or a year. In an educational institution like this, we buy it for an entire year because we use it all the time. And if you are running an independent repair shop, that's probably your best way to go also. But once you have access to the Tesla Toolbox software, and there's instructions on how to configure the software to run on Google Chrome, and you need an Ethernet cable and an adapter on some vehicles to connect Toolbox to your vehicle. Newer Teslas are going to be coming with the 16-pin data link connector, just like any other vehicle. But for now, we've got on the Model 3 right here behind me, I've got a 5-pin connector that plugs in, and on the Model Y, it's just a regular RJ45 Ethernet connector. Okay, let's see how to get into Toolbox 3 and find the procedure to run to take those screenshots and save them to your computer. So as you can see here, I have the Tesla Toolbox software open to the main screen. We need to connect to the vehicle. So we have an Ethernet cable plugged into the laptop and then plugged into the vehicle. And step on the brake pedal to turn the car on. So next, we need to connect the Toolbox software to the vehicle. So we'll click on Connect to Vehicle. Click on Connect. We are connected. Notice right down here, there's a button that says Exit Service Mode Plus. So that tells us that we are in Service Mode Plus. And there are three different modes of operation that we can take these screenshots in. We have Service Mode Plus that we're in right now. And then we have service mode, and then we can exit out of both of those service modes but stay connected. And now we'll come over here to the Actions tab and click on Actions. And up here in the search box, we will type screenshot. The new procedure that was just released with the latest firmware update is this middle one right here, the CID, Center Information Display Screenshot. So I'm going to click on that. It brings up a window telling us that it's going to take a screenshot and return the screenshot. So I will click on Run. It's running. The routine has finished. It is showing us the screenshot that it took, and we have a button right here that reads Download Image. So I'll click on Download Image. It goes right to my Chrome, through my Chrome browser to my Downloads folder. And I can click on that and open it. Here's that screenshot. Okay, if we come back to our little vehicle connection green circle on the screen and click on that, if we come down to Exit Service Mode Plus, so now let's go back to our screenshot procedure. We'll run it again. Notice now we are in just regular service mode. So we'll download that one. Now, if we go to the car, go to the touch screen of the car, push and hold our finger on exit service mode. Now we're back to the user interface screen, the regular screen that anybody that drives the vehicle can see. And we'll come back up to our screenshot procedure. We'll have it run one more time. And here is our downloaded image again of the user interface screen. Now, of course, you can do this on any screen. You need to have a vehicle connection, and then whatever screen you have showing, run this center information display screenshot procedure, and then save it to your computer, and you got it. So for me as a teacher, that really is going to save me a lot of time. We normally would have to take a whole bunch of photographs and edit the photographs and put them in the worksheets that I have for these Tesla vehicles. And the Tesla firmware is changing all the time. So the worksheet that I had designed and was working perfect previously now is different because they changed something on one of the panels in service mode or just on the screen itself. So I'm constantly updating these worksheets. So it's kind of a love-hate relationship. I really like the car and I really like the capabilities and the software, but as Tesla is improving their serviceability for anybody, there's do-it-yourself clinics, there's free access to the service information for anybody now, and then anybody that's serious about doing more than just basic stuff on the cars as far as repairs can get this diagnostic software, which gives you even more capabilities. And this screenshot is one thing that I asked for several months ago. I had somebody from Tesla contact me and say, hey, we noticed you use this software in your classes. You're posting online about it. You made a video about this. I made a video about the Toolbox 3 software in November of 2021. And the guy I spoke with said that they used that video to help improve the Toolbox software. Because back then, once you connected to the car, you didn't know what to do. So it's like, now what? What do I do now? And so I gave them all kinds of feedback on what I thought they could do to improve the Toolbox software. And they've done almost every single thing that I've suggested, including, and I begged for this screenshot capability, finally, just 2 days ago, added this screenshot functionality. And so thank you to the great people at the Tesla Toolbox software and Tesla service mode people and everybody at Tesla that is really making an effort to make these vehicles serviceable by more than just the Tesla service centers, by independent repair facilities and allowing us as educators to teach students how these cars work, how to diagnose and repair them. All right. Well, thank you for watching. Have a good day.